All right, what's going on, guys? This is Jake here with Jake's Trains. As you can tell, I am, once again, not at my house. Actually, if you really look, this isn't even Pennsylvania's architecture style. Forgive me as I am very out of shape. So, as the first video of 2022, and me not being home again, we are at the San Bernardino Santa Fe yard, but I'm actually at the Amtrak station. So we're gonna go ahead, and I got permission from security to come on out here and video some trains. I just want to make sure I got permission, because, you know, between COVID and everything, I also didn't feel like getting a fine, because they have signs posted all around here that say you must have a valid fare ticket in order to be out on the platforms, and without it, it'd be like a $1,500 fine, and I don't want that. So, got permission. But yeah, I've already got a couple that went by. I think there's an Amtrak due, honestly, almost any minute. So, hope you guys enjoy this video, and I'll see you guys at the end. So while you're here, you actually get to watch these guys move the intermodal crates off the trains onto the trucks and
off the trucks and back onto the trains and to stack them and everything. And I thought it was actually pretty interesting. I've never seen it done before. That's why I wanted to include it in this video. The other thing that I think is kind of funny is the fact that when I first heard their moving noise, I actually thought it was the Amazon truck was nearby, because they're the only other ones I've ever heard with those beepers. It's a pretty steep grade. That's impressive.
If you're having a hard time, it's okay to reach out and talk about it. Suicide Prevention Lifeline, 1-800-273-8255.
So I took this picture here, that way you guys could actually see from the other side of that post of how steep of a grade those engines had to go up.
You guys can actually see how steep that grade is. Just in time.
visit MetroLinkTrains.com. Call or text 800-371-5465.
So after all that, my phone started to die and was overheating, so I ran back to my car real quick to charge it and to cool it down. Of course, while that happened, an eastbound UP cool train went by. Surprisingly, it had several Chicago Northwestern cool hoppers on it that were actually in really good shape. So right on the heels of the eastbound UP cool train was an eastbound BNSF train. Second back on the consist was BNSF Warbonnet 760. This is the first one for me to ever actually see. Right after it, of course, when my phone was completely dead, BNSF Warbonnet 707 was leading, heading west.
Alright guys, well that should be just about it for this video. I got quite a bit of footage, so I'm probably going to break this up into a couple videos. Sorry, I just walked up the steps again, so I'm kind of out of breath. Choosing the steps over the elevator, trying to lose some weight here. So, like I said, a couple videos going to be coming out. Missed a couple things. One of them was a UP coal train. Sadly, of course, you know, as soon as my phone died and I went to go charge it, two BNSF Warbonnets passed by, 70 or 760 and 707. I was able to get a picture of 760, but I didn't have that opportunity with 707. My phone was also overheating at that point in time. I think it's time to upgrade my phone. I'll get this video up, and then there's probably gonna be at least a part two, maybe a part three. And there are a couple spots it gets really shaky. I do apologize about that. I'm trying to get a tripod. It's gonna be a little tough whenever I'm on the road to take it with me, but I'll see what I can do. So. All right, guys, I will catch you guys in a little bit. Till the next time, bye.